Hey everybody, how's it going? Just wanted to talk a little bit about today about my battle with depression and how I cope with it. For those of you who know me, know that depression has been a thing in my life, affecting me for quite a while. And I tend to use my music a lot of times to talk what it feels like to go through depression. Like my latest solo piano album came out last year, was purely based on that. But I sometimes worry that maybe people think that that's all that's going on in my life and that I'm always constantly suffering and with it. The reality of it is that I try to cope with it as well as I can, and I feel like I'm having some big successes with it. One of the reasons for that is that I have this little thing where in my web browser I have a bookmark of a web page. It's a random web page, and you're going to see the link in the comments section as part of this post. And this web page, I have no personal connection to it. I have no idea what it is doing as far as the validity or the scientific research associated with it. All I know is that whenever I'm feeling down, I always go to this web page to remind me of the different coping mechanisms that I can use to deal with depression. So I wanted to talk a little bit about that, and of course you can see the page yourself. So the page over here is simply called Coping with Depression. That's on helpguide.org. And it's got a lot of awesome points that I follow and think about a lot. So one of the first coping mechanisms they talk about is reach out and stay connected. And that's something that I feel very strongly about, and that's been a big thing in my life. Getting together with friends, meeting up, having friends come over. I find that sometimes in my solitary life as a composer, it's easy to just box myself in and not want to talk to anybody, even my wife. Sometimes it can be difficult, but this reaching out, finding a way to support others, volunteering, being in the lives of other people really, really makes it a lot easier to deal with. This website talks about top 10 tips for staying connected. Talk to one person about your feelings. Help someone else by volunteering. Have lunch or coffee with a friend. Accompany someone to the movies, a concert, small get-together, call or email an old friend, go for a walk. You know, these are huge things. Tip number two, do things that make you feel good. Very big in my life. Do things you enjoy. Well, I love watching movies, sports, so that's a nice diversion from what I do. I really like to go for walks, be physically active as much as I can, spend time outdoors. Website talks about supporting your health. Aim for 8 hours of sleep, definite check in my life. I don't really know if I can function very well without 8 hours sleep. Mind you, sometimes I can't sleep, but then I usually catch up another night. Keep stress in check. Always working on that. Practice relaxation techniques. In the past few years, I've adopted meditation as part of a regular part of my routine. So that's pretty cool too. Tip number three, get moving. Being physically active, really, really huge in my life. So I find that when I'm physically tired, it's harder to be emotionally tired, if that makes any sense. So going for long hikes or walks, it's really awesome. Lisa and I, my wife, we pair up. We often go for a walk. We'll often talk. Take dog for a walk. I don't have a dog. And a lot of people say, including Lisa, says we should get a dog, or it might be nice to get a dog in the future. And, you know, I've read and I know, you know, just taking care of families, pets and stuff, they are so therapeutic in your life. I just can't pull the trigger though on my busy life. I would just feel so bad about that. Tip number four, eat a healthy depression fighting diet. Don't skip meals. Very rarely do. Minimize sugar and refined carbs. For those of you who don't know, other than depression, I also suffer from Crohn's disease. So a gluten-free, grain-free diet, basically a paleo diet, has been a really big thing. Eating organic. We're really into naturopathic medicines, so exploring that a lot. That's a huge thing in our life, and taking vitamins your gut is so important in overall health, be it emotional or physical. So enzymes are a huge thing, vitamin D, all this kind of stuff. Tip number five, get a daily dose of sunlight. As I mentioned earlier, going for a walk is huge, twice a day. Since I work at home and we live in a condo, it's really important to get out. And especially at this time of year in the summertime, oh my gosh, it's so lovely. And just, you know, just taking off, you know, a sweater and wearing short sleeves and letting the sun, it just feels so good and stuff. So dealing with the winter blues, even in the winter, I will go out no matter how cold it is and sometimes painful. Got a really good winter jacket, and I don't use the winter to sort of take away from that. Tip number six, challenge negative thinking. This is the really hard part. The website talks about negative or unrealistic ways of thinking that fuel depression. So have I suffered from these things? All or nothing thinking. Absolutely. I do. I'm so guilty of that, especially being an artist and being self-employed. I overgeneralize everything. That's for sure. I definitely do that. Diminish the positive. Oh my gosh, the self-esteem issues is tough. Jumping to conclusions. Emotional reasoning. Reasoning, using words like should or should not, and labeling things. All of these things I definitely go through. So how do I get out of this? Meditation is huge. Talking with loved ones, sharing my feelings, trying not to get insular, trying to get outward. That's really huge for sure. And finally, the big thing here is when to get professional help for depression. I have gotten psychotherapy before. I found it very helpful. Recently, I did this type of technique called tapping, which is a combination of physical tapping along with like a psychotherapy type of thing. And that was an interesting experience as well. The one thing I've never done is I've never gotten into medication to control my my depression. And that's not to say that medication is bad. It's just I'm personally really weary of it for my situation, because I really want to work as hard as I can on everything that I've already talked about on this list before I would ever get to that point. And furthermore, I guess I'm a little paranoid being an artist if the side effects would somehow hamper my creativity. Anyway, that's where I'm coming from. I hope you found this chat helpful. It's been quite a journey for me, especially this past year since that piano album came out, because that's sort of been the impetus for me to share more publicly what it's like to deal with depression. And I can't thank enough all the friends and family and supporters who have been on this journey with me. So thanks very much. I hope some of the stuff I talked about helps you or people you know, and this webpage that I'm sharing also helps. Cheers.